您诸位好啊，我想您诸位不懂中国话，所以我现在要说英国话。 The world today is passing through the most tremendous period of a readjustment that mankind has seen, and the real desire to do away with war is being manifested. Peace on earth and goodwill toward men can only be accomplished by the mutual respect and understanding of one nation towards another. Since I have been in this country at this time, through my writing and lecturing, I have endeavored to create a better understanding between China and the United States by presenting the beautiful, artistic, and the cultural side of Chinese life. I am grieved that this side of Chinese life is very little known here. Although China is a very old country, she is a young republic. She is striving manfully to develop and become up to date. This will take time. But the Chinese flapper is not far behind her American sister in her desire to become emancipated. Rapid transportation has brought China and the United States to each other's doorway. And the greatest stride of all has been the sound film. And in this opportunity to address the millions of people who listen to Movietone News, I feel especially privileged and grateful.
Hi everyone, this is DGSpitzer. Hope you enjoy my latest colorization video. Today's footage is from 90 years ago, January 3rd, 1930. It's a speech by Princess Sterling about world peace, who was a former interpreter as the First Lady-in-Waiting for Empress Dowager Cixi in the late Qing Dynasty of China. The original footage is from Moving Image Research Collections, University of South Carolina, Fox Movietone News Collection. Thanks so much for your support. The picture referenced for AI colorization process are collected from several museum archives, such as Palace Museum in Beijing and the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York. Thanks to Vivi Has a Dream helping me find those sources. You can check out her YouTube channel as well. Additionally, I set up my new pipeline of AI restoration this time, with PaddleGAN, DAIN, DeepRemaster, Deep Exemplar-Based Colorization, DFDNet module of BasicSR, and the Topaz Video Enhance AI for upscaling, which gives me a great improvement about facial enhancement and clothing colorization for detailed historical dresses. I feel grateful to find these amazing AI tools. If you're interested, please go check out their projects. As far as I know, there are also many Chinese developers contributing in this open source AI community. Alright, if you like my video, don't forget to subscribe and give me a thumb up. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye!